Transcription and Disease Laboratory was established in the year 2000 in Molecular Biology and Genetics Unit of JNCASR. The major focus of this lab is to understand how gene functions inside the human cell and how is it related to disease, and using this knowledge whether we can design modern therapeutics. So the first thing the lab started with to discover the how genes and genomes are organized in the human cell. In that course, we first discovered the multifunctional protein coactivator 4PC4 is a chromatin protein. And today, what we find that this protein is indeed a very important protein for the genome integrity. And that is why more than 70% human breast cancer we tested, we find this protein is down-regulated. Very interestingly, what we find, where PC4 is not there, the cells are radiation resistant. So this clearly indicates the therapeutic value of PC4 in terms of the therapeutics, in the radiation therapeutics. On the other hand, we also find that the fundamental mechanism by which PC4 in a whole organism is involved for the retention of memory. If PC4 is not there, we have shown in the mice doesn't forget anymore. So this discovered how the mechanism of the memory extinction happens because of this protein. On the other hand, in another project, at the same time, lab started to understand what you call is the genome dynamics. Means how genes are folded and unfolded by the chaperone proteins, and that controls the expression of the gene. And what we find is that the genes which are expressing requires this protein called NPM1, and a chemical modification like acetylation is very important for that. Interestingly, we find this protein NPM1 is histone chaperone protein, which actually regulates the epigenetic enzymes like acetyltransferase P300. My lab at the same time started working on the most fatal cancer for Indian population is oral cancer. And what we find in the oral cancer, the acetylation is extremely high. And one of the major cause for the hyperacetylation could be the NPM1 itself. So NPM1 and couple of other protein regulated hyperacetylation is one of the very important factor for the oral cancer progressions. Interestingly, lab discovered several small molecules which can target the acetyltransferase activity specifically and non-specifically, and we find that in the mice model we can really regulate the, we can control, we can actually reduce the oral cancer growth, and that thereby this epigenetic therapeutics could be a very important alone or in combination. In the same course, our lab has discovered many other small molecules which can target arginine methyltransferase, which can activate the acetyltransferase activity. The activation of acetyltransferase activity by the first small molecule known is the CTPB or TTK21 was the first one we discovered. And now what we find, using this molecule, we can actually induce the acetylation in the mice brain. And this induction of acetylation induce the memory, long-term memory. So which at present has taken to the different field when we could completely recover the tau mice or the neurodegenerative mice models memory using this molecule. But how could we take this molecule into the brain? We could take this molecule into the brain by our own discovered carbon nanosphere. In collaboration with my colleague in chemistry, Professor Ishwarmurthy's group, we have found that the glucose-derived carbon nanosphere can go to the brain and deliver these activators. Based on this unique property of this activator, the carbon nanosphere, now Department of Biotechnology, Government of India has selected this as a drug delivery vehicle in the brain. And DVT has sanctioned a very interesting translational project for that purpose. I must say, not only we have been able to publish several international papers through these, several of our discoveries are right now in the catalogs of the companies. Throughout the world, people are using our small molecule compounds, our antibodies, and several companies have shown interest to take our discovery to the next level of the translation. Thank you.